This is Pedro from Music by Pedro. Today we're gonna talk about cleaning your saxophone. So there's a couple little things that I like to do when I'm done playing my instrument, and I'm gonna go over each one of them so you guys know how it is that I take care of my instrument, and it's definitely a huge suggestion on something that I think you guys should do also. So usually after I'm done playing, the first thing I wanna do is take the reed off. I don't wanna try to put things away yet because the reed is the most important part of, the most sensitive part of the instrument. So I like to take that guy off. Now, to take care of my mouthpiece and my reed, I actually have this little guy right here. This is the BG clarinet and saxophone mouthpiece cleaner. And so I use one side of it very carefully. I use it to wipe down the side of the reed so the reed is nice and clear and dry. That's gonna help make them last a long time. Then I take the ligature off just like that. We don't need to really do anything to the ligature. And then the nice thing about this cloth is that it actually has a very stiff string, so it's very easy to just poke right on through and then just pull around the other side, and you can get a nice clean dry mouthpiece, especially with the inside, because that's where all your moisture is going to build up. So you're going to do that maybe 1, 2, 3 times depending on how much you've played, and then once you're done, it is clean as a whistle. And then just do a nice little wipe down on the outside, make sure you get all the spit, and then the mouthpiece is nice and clean, ready to go. Okay, you're done with that. Now this cloth here is a microfiber cloth, and it's super, super high quality, very absorbent, and it's nice and soft too, so it'll never hurt your finish, whether you have a lacquered finish or whether you have a vintage finish or like a brush finish or anything like that. Doesn't matter, it won't affect any of that. Then you take the neck, and you're gonna stick the same mouthpiece and neck cleaner, just like that. Once it pops out, grab it, slowly pull it out, because then it'll allow the cloth to get more moisture. You do it maybe 2, 3 times. Here's the second time. And we pull, and it is clean as a whistle. If you let moisture sit in the neck, it's going to allow mildew and possibly rust to start developing inside the neck. Right now, it is very clean as a whistle inside, so it's definitely gonna last a much longer period of time, and it won't smell or have any sort of weird smells. It won't turn into a biology project, basically. So really, really nice little mouthpiece and neck cleaner that I use to really take care of the neck, because all the moisture is here. Something else I'd like to do also is I like to take just the side of it, and then I wipe down the connecting part that goes into the saxophone itself. And then once my neck is done, I can put it away, just like that, okay? So that is this guy here. This is model numbers BGA31. They make this, I believe, for all clarinets. So no matter what clarinet you have, this is gonna be a perfect size. It won't get caught inside anything. I use this for my clarinet and my alto, my soprano, my tenor, my barry, all my mouthpieces, and definitely all my necks too. So it's really, really nice. The other thing that I like about it is that it fits all clarinets, which is really nice because it fits my clarinet and my bass clarinet and the necks for both of them. So really, really nice cloth. This is the BGA31. And again, it's so soft. And then, you know, once you feel like it's gotten a little gunky, a little grimy, just throw it in the wash, give it a good wash. It's clean, it's good to go. You can wash it, oh, so many times. I don't have the exact number. We can wash it probably tens of hundreds of times, as long as you don't dry it too much. I think what they say is dry it low heat, I think, so that the high heat won't damage the microfiber. That's just a common thing with all microfibers for you to know. But yeah, and then after you put it away, the lace actually kind of folds in half. So it's really, really nice and easy to store. You just roll it into itself, fits anywhere in my instrument. And it's definitely a must have if you play saxophone or clarinet. So you've got the body now. There's a couple of options on how to take care of the body. The first one is you can use a swab just like this, and then you're gonna drop it in the bell first, like that. It's got a little weight. Throw the rest of the lace in there, and then you're going to disconnect, turn it upside down till the string comes out, and then you're going to just wrap it around your hand, slowly pull it up, and slowly pull it up, and then you're done. Pretty clean. You can do it good 2 times. My rule of thumb is do it twice at least. You'll definitely be in good shape. Let's do it a second time. And then there you go. grab, wrap around your hands, slowly pull up, it's not a race, and then it's nice and clean inside, okay? So that takes care of the body. Now, they do have a second option that you can definitely take advantage of. Once you're done with it, if you wanna take the extra step, you wanna take care of the outside. You can clean the outside, you can wipe it down with a cloth. This is my favorite cloth here. It is massive. This is the A62L also, and I really love how big it is because it allows you to really grab the whole horn and wipe it down all the way around the bell and then around the thumb rest, octave key. Basically, a lot, the most important stuff that you want to wipe down is where your hands make contact, because your hands have oils, and then the oils will sit here for a while, and then they'll start causing damage to the instrument. Right around the pearls on the right hand, and then you can do the rest of the keys. Now, this is nice, and it works for some people. Here's a cool little thing they also make. This is the A62G, and it's a glove. So it's super handy, because I know that sometimes when I'm cleaning my instrument, I've had the displeasure of poking my finger with a spring by accident. This will definitely protect you from doing that, and it's much easier to get all the way around. So you just basically put it on and just wipe down everything all the way down like that. Make sure you get all the keys, tops of all the keys, F sharp key, side keys, also very, very important to get those, pinky keys at the bottom, and then right around the front, same thing with the bell. And it's a really nice fit. Once you're done, you just take it off, roll it up, and put it away, okay? Very, very nice. Once you're done with the whole instrument and you're ready to put it away, just put the neck cap on, like so. You don't need to tighten the screw or anything like that. The neck cap's job is to prevent the octave key from getting caught or bending into anything. So once you're good to go, you just grab it by the bell and put it in the case, okay guys? So it's a very, very simple lesson, but it makes such a world difference. Your instrument is going to last so much longer. It's not gonna smell funny, and it's gonna be clean. And that's a really good feeling after you're done with a long practice session or rehearsal. Wipe up everything, clean it all up, make sure that it's dry, because once you put it in the case and you close it up, you're combining bacteria from our mouth, darkness, which is not good for bacteria because it allows it to grow even more, and your whole case will start smelling funky, and your whole saxophone or instrument is gonna become a biology project. So it's very, very cool stuff. Definitely my preferred things. Again, this is the neck and mouthpiece cleaner. This is the A31. Again, it works with all saxophones and all clarinets. Super, super skinny, and it's got the really stiff lace, which is perfect to get around the neck. Then once you're done, you can do the full body swab, which is this guy here. It's got a little weight on the string, so you go in bell first, all the way up. And then once you're done with the inside, you can do the outside by either using the glove or you can use the microfiber cloth. Completely up to you. I'm gonna put the links to all this stuff below so you guys can definitely check it out. If you have any questions about anything, please let me know in regards to cleaning. I'm gonna do a different video for the tenor because I got some really cool stuff that I use that's a little bit different than the alto. So be sure to stay tuned for that video in the future. Again, guys, that's basically it. Thank you, as always, for watching. If you have any questions, drop them below. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.